tell me about this lawsuit. Why did you file the lawsuit? What are the key points?
Well, the timing of the lawsuit is now, because in reality, we could have filed that lawsuit the minute after we saw the video. We chose to really be tactful as far as letting the family have an opportunity to lay their son, their grandson, their brother to rest in a proper way. But it's time that we get some answers. So the lawsuit is being filed now because we want to take the next step to seek justice for Antoine and to get the hard answers that we deserve.
Talk about excessive and deadly force. You talk about the hands being shown. Explain some of that to me, because that's obviously the basis.
Yeah, so I mean, the crux of this lawsuit is really just what you've seen on the video, which is that we feel that Officer Rosefield didn't act as a reasonable officer would have acted under the same and similar circumstances that were prevailing on that fateful night. If he had acted reasonably, Antoine Rose would be standing next to me. So that's the gist of the lawsuit. There is an ancillary portion of the lawsuit where you see the mayor named and the police chief named and the borough named. And those really go to the theory of the fish stinks from the head down. And what we're saying there is we're casting a larger net. We're saying, well, the proper vetting should have taken a place to weed out this candidate from the police force. If you would have done scratched the surface a bit on his past with Pitt or these other agencies, you would have found that he isn't an appropriate candidate to be hired and to be given a gun and a badge and arrest power. Or if they did vet him and know that history, that's even worse. So whether you go left or right that they didn't vet him or they vetted him and hired him, either way, they're wrong. And then the second issue is training. We learned that the East Pittsburgh Police Department, through the District Attorney of Stephen Zappala, who had informed us, they didn't have standard operating procedures. So how could we be guaranteed or even assured in the slightest that this officer was properly trained when we know that the department he was hired to work for didn't even have standard operating procedures? And then there's the actual facts that we see on the video, which show that he wasn't following standard operating procedures. The reason the video began to run in the first place is because he was talking so violently and screaming and shouting in a way that was not becoming of an officer. I mean, officers have to take a tone with individuals, have to give verbal commands all the time. In fact, that's proper. But the way this fellow was talking, according to the witness, was just other level. And that's what caused her to flip on the camera in the first place. So we believe that he violated a number of procedures besides just that one. For example, acting when you have three individuals in a car and you don't have any backup. And obviously, the obvious one is 30 feet away with an individual running away, empty-handed, no gun, and shooting him in the back three times in rapid succession without even so much as shouting a warning. You know, the federal law that we cited requires you to give an individual a proper warning and then an opportunity to respond to that warning. There's no way in this video that Officer Rosefield gave there's no warning given, and there's clearly no opportunity to comply with that warning. And that's a fateful problem for East Pittsburgh in this lawsuit. So we feel very strongly about what we filed. So warning has to be given before you take the next action. So you could be given a number of warnings during an incident, but when an individual alights from a vehicle and is running away, he's no harm to you, he's no harm to anyone else at that time. There's proper manner in which you can apprehend that individual. And in this situation, firing your gun three times into his back from 30 feet away is just not what we believe to be the proper response. And that's not to say, I'm not condemning officers in general. I get stopped in the hallway all the time in the criminal courthouse here in Pittsburgh, and officers take me to task. And I welcome that discussion, because there's a lot of excellent officers out there that are doing their job. You know, officers run towards danger when others flee from danger. And they need to be commended for that. And 99% of the officers do things the right way and are excellent at their jobs and should be commended for that. What we're trying to do is take someone who is a known bad apple and say, hey, why did you hire this guy? You shouldn't have hired this guy. And we should root those individuals out, because we're giving them a badge and we're giving them a gun, and they're going to use their violent propensity in the wrong fashion. And secondly, we're calling out the individuals who are hiring them and who are creating the policies in these boroughs and saying, hey, do a better job. Do a better job making sure that you know who you're hiring. Do a better job making sure that if you do hire someone, you train them before you put them on the street.
Anything else you want to say about the parents, how they're feeling at this point? Obviously, that's tough.
Yeah, this is a special family. They're extremely tight. They're nothing I do as a litigator is going to take away the pain that they're feeling and is going to bring back Antoine. But what we have an obligation to do as a litigation team between my brother Monty and Ashley Cagle and I is we want to bring light to this issue for our city and the country, but also we want to make sure that Antoine's remembered forever in a positive manner.